This is the smart home app for the Midea air conditioner. You might be looking for a different app, but this is apparently the one that they are using now. After you add your device, you can see you have a picture of it right there. You can add more devices as you like. It shows you your fan speed. It shows you what mode you're on, and it shows you your temperature. You can adjust up and down right here. You can also see that the unit is currently on, which is why it has this kind of air condition wave coming out of it. And then we have an on-off button right here. This is everything we do from the main screen. We can add another device by selecting the plus sign in the upper corner here. And then we have some settings that we can have for the overall application, whether we want to have our front page being large cards or small cards. You can also change your wallpaper. So if you don't like kind of the sky blue, they give you some options here. I'll change it to that one to give you an example and save. And there you can see the background's kind of gray. Again, that's kind of overall stuff. We've got some shortcuts, but remember, this is not necessarily for the air conditioner itself, but the application overall. If we want to adjust our air conditioner, we simply tap into it and it's going to bring us into the air conditioner itself. Here you can see temperature first and foremost. It will tell you my outdoor temperature as well as my current indoor temperature. There's a sliding bar so we can adjust it by grabbing it like this, or I can simply use the plus and minus signs. If I select the temperature, it's going to bring me to a graph, but we can access that graph from another location as well. Coming down, we have our mode. Selecting this, I can select auto, cool, dry, and fan because those are the only things available to me for this particular model. I have fan speed. I can adjust right here, or there's an auto toggle right there. I can select that and it will put it into auto mode. And I have to remember to stop hitting the back button. Moving down, we have up and down. That is our swing arm activation. We have LED. We can turn off our LED. We can also mute the unit so we don't hear those beep indicators when we hit it. We also have a boost mode. Selecting this will push the fans to their maximum speed, but is not always accessible depending on the mode that you're in. And you might hear the fan speed actually ramp up behind me because it's right over my right shoulder. Here we have our sleep curve. We can turn this on and off, or we can come in here and make some adjustments. This will allow you to kind of set your temperature based on an 8-hour sleeping period, and then you can set your fan speed during that period and then power off after sleep, yes or no. So once your sleep time is over, power the unit off. So hypothetically, if I'm starting my sleep and I should be getting 8 hours, right now it's starting at under 70 degrees, but let's say I need it cooler than that. So for the first couple hours, I need about 65, 64. And then once I'm pretty sure I'm asleep, maybe I can tolerate up to 75, and I can adjust those for the 3 hours in the middle there. And then, hey, as I'm getting ready to wake up, I kind of want it a little cooler, so I can adjust it like that, and the air conditioner will dynamically change during that time period. I also have change to smart curve, which will kind of automatically do something for me. Here we have our sleep duration up there. You can do 4, 6, 8, 10, or 12. God, I wish I could do 12 hours of sleep. And then once you're ready, you hit submit, and that will set up your sleep curve. You also have a favorites. This will allow you to set up energy saver, a baby mode, and a pet mode. If any of these are enabled, we come in here and we can set the mode, the temperature, and then the fan speed. And then if we want eco mode or not, and then run when power's on, meaning when the device is first powered on, and then label pet. So you could hypothetically have different levels for different situations. Up here in the upper right hand corner, we can also press the plus sign to create our own label. Notice right there, favorite one, and those would all live under your favorites that you could just kind of quick toggle instead of messing with the controls to get your optimal temperature. And right here we have eco mode. Currently it's on. You could toggle that on and off from there. Power on or off button right there, and then a timer. So this is going to be for our scheduling. Right now I don't have a schedule. I can click the icon right there and it will make a schedule based on my location, and I can select a different time zone if I wanted to. Schedule, turn on and off, turn on, turn off, and then you have turn on times, turn off times, whether this is weekdays, evenings, or custom. You could set it for all the time. Settings, what's your temperature rating, and then label name, and then you could set, and that will be a schedule that you have access to. And those are the basic controls that we have for the Midea air conditioner. If we come to the upper right hand corner here, clicking the hamburger button will allow us to get into the actual settings of the app and the AC unit right here. This is a troubleshooting or a diagnostics thing. We have operations monitor. There is actually actually an SD card in the Midea that's saving information so that you can access it from here. However, if you do not attach it to the application and then set it up, even if you've run it for 3 weeks like I have, there'll be no data in here. But right here we can see, since I actually hooked everything up and have been playing with the application, we could see temperature, indoor temperature, outdoor temperature in the back there. We can do our humidity and room humidity, outdoor humidity, and target humidity. I don't have a target humidity, so there we go. And then mode, it was off, which it wasn't, but it has no data because it wasn't actively saving that to the app before. And then we have mode cool time, and then statistics for the last 7 days only. But from any of these, there is the ability to go back in time. And like I said, there's no information prior to me setting it up in the app. Here we have our device time zone, our units, Fahrenheit or Celsius, about this device. There's gonna be sensitive information in there. Not gonna show you all that. Firmware update, refresh function, which there you go, it refreshed successfully. Plugin version, service request, and contact us, and share. If you wanted to share access to your air conditioner, you can do that and simply type somebody's email address and you can give them access to your air conditioner controls. But that has been everything that we can do with the smart home app for the Midea air conditioner.